I'm here at Imaginables today for the unveiling of Ultimaker's new Pro Bundle Pack. This is a pretty amazing achievement, and in fact, I'm waiting to go in to hear what all these features are all about, so let's jump into that straight away. We're here today at Imaginables for the launch of Ultimaker's new Pro Bundle Pack. The Pro Bundle Pack actually consists of the S5 Ultimaker machine that's been released before, as well as an air manager and the newly released Material Station. And the Material Station itself is pretty amazing. This, I think, is a complete game changer when it comes to the world of 3D printing. I'm here with Jesse Blok, who happens to be the service and sales engineer, and we're going to talk about some of the new features that are coming out with this Pro Bundle. Jesse, in your terms, what do you think is the benefit of this new Pro Bundle?
Well, in my opinion right now, Ultimaker is really allowing a customer to print 24/7. I think people have experienced that the filament sensor is a great addition to the S5, and now they're going for the next step.
I love the idea of being able to run a machine 24 hours a day. I know that within my own printing experience, I don't sleep very well when I'm running a print because I'm worried that filament might get caught or there may be a failure. Talk about how that's being addressed in this new bundle pack.
Yeah, so Ultimaker has the material station, which isn't only a material station, but also controls the humidity. So a customer can load its spools, Ultimaker spools, third-party materials. The material station will either recognize the material, check how much is on the spool, if the user has handled them correctly, and then you'll put them into the pre-feeders, and it will switch automatically when one spool has been emptied. It'll continue printing with the next one.
So let me get this right. I've got a material station where I can load up different types of material and the machine changes it over. And just in case I've opened that material and I've let it sit there, it's actually humidity controlled within that space?
Yes.
That's pretty amazing. I haven't heard anything like that in any other 3D printing solutions.
Yeah, well, Ultimaker has really listened to their customers, I think, with this one. Especially PVA, it dissolves with water, so humidity in the air is also something. So with the dehumidifier, they try to enhance the experience a customer has with it. And especially for a company, all the hassle changing materials and those are man hours. So if you can avoid them, it's better, right?
This new Pro Pack, it's aimed at the hobbyist or kind of a business level?
It's on the business level. Like if a hobbyist is really looking forward to expand like its startup company by adding a printer and possibly gaining a few extra hands, of course. But it's like the crossover area from small business to medium business area.
Cool. The other thing that's in this Pro Pack is an air filter. So that air filter, is it just a HIPS air filter? What makes this different from the other options you can get with 3D printers?
So right now, this filter has been really validated. It's an EPA filter. It filters 95%, and it focuses on all the particles when 3D printing, and lasts for about 1,500 hours, and the machine will tell you when you need to replace it.
I'm getting the feeling that this is a real departure from the other Ultimaker machines, in the sense that this is kind of a workhorse. It just keeps going.
Yeah, so that's what they're fully focusing at right now. With all the research being done by Ultimaker R&D, the people really focus on continuous printing. Maintaining the print area where it's printing or the build volume in a constant state, so the prints come out like they should.
This is kind of game changing. There's a lot of printers out there that are going from like the hobby level going into kind of a business level, but this is answering questions that it seems that the community's had for a long time. Just curious, since you have access to one of these machines, what are you keen on making with this Pro Bundle?
I think right now we're mostly looking to print larger models, which at times need a lot of support. So we're able to empty our spools, print long durations of time over weekends, so we don't have to come back and switch materials. And concerning applications, Ultimaker with their carbon infused filaments are getting more and more into the technical area. So I'm thinking that we're also looking at printing more and more jigs and fixtures, but also even components that can be loaded at times.
I love this guy because he's a businessman. I'm asking you personally, what would you like to make on that machine given that you've got access?
In that case, since I'm Dutch, I'm looking to develop and print all the interfacings for a bike in carbon infused filaments, and then use just regular carbon tubing, gluing it together, and see if it can hold my weight.
I'm looking forward to seeing that. I really am, because I think that's exactly what this technology allows you to do. To be able to go, first of all, print in carbon fiber on a machine that's kind of history has been all about making and creating, that allows anyone to be able to express themselves the way they want. Can I ride the bike when you finish it?
We'll try.
Okay. I might have to slim down a bit, but we'll definitely get it going. No problem. Worries. Jesse, okay. Thank you so much.
Yeah, have a good one. Cheers.
Great. We're really lucky to have the VP of the Asia Pacific region for the Ultimaker, Ben Ten, here. And I just want to talk to you really quickly, not just about the Pro Pack that's come out, but Ultimaker in general. So first of all, this is an incredibly exciting proposition. I know that for myself and from a lot of the people who are going to be watching this, we're not business people, but we love the idea of being able to have a continuous feed with material. Is that something that Ultimaker might be able to consider in the future, making this material station available for people who already have machines or maybe have the S3 or S5?
Well, it all depends. Again, like what I mentioned during my presentation just now, all these machines or accessories are driven by what our customer wants. So if there's a requirement by the people in our community on the material station for the newer machine, for the older machines, yeah, why not? We'll definitely consider that, for sure.
Absolutely. So I got people to write below that they want this to see this sort of stuff.
Please.
And when it comes to the material station itself, it's pretty amazing. This, of all the things that I've seen in the last 12 months, this is really the game changer as far as I'm concerned. Yeah. I'd love to give you my credit card right now and just be like, I want three. Because to be able to utilize a machine that runs 24 hours a day, and I know that even from my experience, and I'm talking in the last 10 years, being able to put some material on it and wondering, is it going to run out? Do I lose the print?
Right.
Is there a way for me to save it?
Right.
That is something that just hasn't been addressed. And in this Pro Bundle Pack, you have this material station that is just a complete game changer.
Yep, exactly. This is basically a system required by a lot of our customers. Not only is able to supply almost unlimited materials 24/7, not just 24. It also has a temperature and moisture control within that environment. So it's kept at 40% humidity. So your materials are safe from moisture and what have you out there.
Again, that is something that has been discussed and might have been addressed, but it's one thing. So we discuss humidity and moisture, discuss material. Sometimes they put a sensor to turn the machine off, but it hasn't been this continuous. And on top of that, we have the air manager, which is not just a HIPS filter, but it is actually, well, why don't you tell?
Well, it's not just a HEPA filter. It filters, up to 95% of a UPF. But at the same time, it actually regulates the temperature within the entire chamber.
Mm-hmm.
So it basically helps optimize the print quality of whatever materials that's loaded into the material station. So if you have a particular spool that has the UFC, it automatically senses that for this particular spool, a certain regulated temperature and airflow is required. So it basically automatically senses and changes according to that particular spool. So that's why we need to use spool with UFCs.
Right. So the machine knows what material you're using and it optimizes the environment to get the best results.
Exactly.
And again, that's phenomenal. You're talking about a completely enclosed system.
Yes.
So I've got different types of material that's compatible with the machine. I put it into the material center. How does it know what I'm using?
If that particular spool has an NFC, we can tell what material you're using and what kind of print environment will best suit that whole print profile.
Great. What's NFC stand for?
So basically, NFC stands for near field communication. So the system is able to detect basically what is the optimal print profile for that particular spool.
Fantastic. So the spools have a little chip that it reads, and then it takes the specs off that chip, and it configures what's going on.
Exactly.
Why is that important?
Well, it's important because different materials have in a different environment have different print profile. So in order to have best print quality, the environment has to be conducive, right? So that's why the print head is able to regulate the temperature, the airflow within the air manager, all can be all regulated just simply by the NFC.
Fantastic. And where did the specs for these filaments come from? Do we have to plug them in or?
No. I mean, all the material supplier, for example, the large companies or even Ultimaker, they will give you the specs. And all these specs are actually found within Cura.
Okay.
So once you're able to download Cura and you're able to locate that particular part number, the optimized print profile is already available within Cura. And then you can just print it off the rack, easily as that.
Before we let you go, I want to talk a little bit about Ultimaker itself, because Ultimaker started really as a ground maker-based
startup. It's a real startup.
Using technology that was around, but refining it. Cura happens to be one of those things that someone interested in 3D printing would be familiar with, but not a lot of people realize that it actually is the software side of the Ultimaker kind of ecosystem.
Exactly.
And Ultimaker is more than happy for people to utilize that, what they know from the software side?
Definitely. I mean, Cura is an open source, that's 95% developed by Cura, by Ultimaker.
Yeah.
So we are more than happy to have, you know, end users using them. It's free for use. So the more you use, it's good for us. Why? Because you're actually helping us propagate, you know, how Ultimaker is. It's not just, you know, taking in from the community, but also giving back to the community.
Perfect.
That's how we are.
Perfect. And that's what I really love about Ultimaker. The machines are tried and tested. That's an amazing thing. You're talking about technology that might have been available before, but we're not. Ultimaker doesn't go and try to reinvent the wheel. They stay with what works and they stay with what's tried. I personally love these machines. I don't have one in my stable, but maybe we can change that.
Yeah.
but I've had a lot of use with them in some of the roles that I've worked with, and I love these machines because it does what it needs to do.
Yeah.
I always joke that 3D printing is not videotape technology. Exactly. You don't put a tape in, record, and it works every time. But Ultimaker comes very close to that analogy of being a videotape machine in the sense of reliability and getting the result you want.
Ease of use.
That's not in the professional level.
Exactly.
It's not, you know, in this, and I know you're marketing professional here, but hobbyists, makers, makerspaces, libraries, schools can afford these machines and get results that are repeatable.
Yeah, exactly.
And it's pretty amazing. It's great to have you here. Thank you so much for having some time.
Thanks for having me, Gil.
Yeah, absolutely. If you're interested in 3D printing and the Ultimaker, this machine is definitely something you want to take a look at. This machine has just launched literally today. So again, I want to thank Ben for spending some time with us. And I'm looking forward to delving deeper into the S5 and the actual Pro Pack itself. I'm really hoping to come back here at Imaginables and run some tests to see really what this Pro Pack will allow people to deliver.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Ben.
Thanks, Gil.
Thank you
so much.
If this is the first time you've come to my channel, I invite you to hit the subscribe button and the bell icon so you don't miss out on any other videos about technology and maker craft.